Good evening, my dear aspirants. Today, we are going to discuss Ponaka Kanakamma. This topic is most demanded from more aspirants. So, Ponaka Kanakamma, she belongs to the Nellore. And she was a social worker, activist, and freedom fighter, imprisoned over a year as a disciple of Mahatma Gandhi in India. She founded Sri Kasturi Vidyalayam, a large school for girls in Nellore. Ponaka Kanakamma was born in Nellore district on 10th, 1892 at Potlapudi. Her father was Morupuri Kondareddy and mother Kamamma. She hailed from very rich landlord community. She married her maternal uncle Subbaram Reddy, a rich landlord from the Potlapudi village near Nellore. She was 8 years old at the time of her marriage. As her husband was traditional, she was not allowed to attend school. Though she was no formal schooling, she acquired proficiency in Telugu, Hindi, and Sanskrit by her own efforts. She participated actively in the national movement. In 1907, when Bipin Chandrapal and his wife visited Nellore in connection with the Vande Mataram movement, she hosted the couple. At that time, she was only 16 years of age. In 1913, she started Sujalaranjini Samajam in Potlapudi village near Nellore to serve the society. With the help of her youngest brother-in-law, Pattabhiram Reddy, who was involved in the library movement, she established this Sujalaranjini Samajam and Vivekananda Grandalayam in Potlapudi village near Nellore to serve the society. Her friends started libraries in nearby villages, Pongaduvuru, Kandrika, and Kotturu. She worked for the upliftment of Harijanas and poor, that is outside caste and poor people in Nellore district. Her friends established Vivekananda Library in Kotturu in the year 1913 with the help of people Nellore, Ramanayudu, and others. From 1916 to 1919, for a brief period, she was under the spell of revolutionary politics, later became the ardent principal disciple of the Mahatma Gandhi. In 1917, Andhra Mahasabha held at Nellore. She attended for this Andhra Mahasabha. She also delivered the speech at Andhra Mahasabha. Potlapudi became the center for Home Rule movement. She also started the Home Rule movement from the Potlapudi. She preserved revolutionary literature and she served weapons to the revolutionary people. She encouraged Nellore youth to enter into the national movement. In 1919, Darcy Senchaya received her hosting after return from the jail. In the same year, she started Harijana Boys Home. The Andhra revolutionary hero, Alluri Sita Ramaraju, also received her host. She purchased 13 acres of land in Potlapudi village, about 8 miles from the Nellore on the banks of River Penna, and handed over the land to revolutionary friends for concealing firearms and for firing practice. She became the follower of Mahatma. She donated the land to establish Pinakini Ashram. The Pinakini Ashram on 7th April 1921, Mahatma Gandhi inaugurated in Potlapudi village about 6 miles from the Nellore. She sold out all his ornaments for this ashram. Chaturvedula Krishnaya, that is C.V. Krishna, Digumarthi Hanumantarao, his wife Krishna Bai, and Kondapudi Punnaya were the founder members of this ashram. Karakamma participated in the non-cooperation movement and salt satyagraha. She underwent 1.5 years rigorous imprisonment in 2 installments at Raipur, Rayaveluru. Rajaji, Bezavada Gopal Reddy, Durgabai and many others were important freedom fighters were her co-prisoners in Rayaveluru. In 1923, she founded Kasturi Devi Vidyalayam as a part of Gandhiji's constructive program, a school for girls in Nelluru. And Gandhiji laid the foundation stone for the permanent building in 1929. In 1944, Kanakamma exchanged 1 to 5 acres of the school site in Pagutota, Nelluru, for a sprawling 20 acres of land in the outskirts of Nelluru, and a school building was built in this site with the donation made by the Thikkavarapu Ramireddy and around 1947 or so. Kasturi Devi Vidyalayam campus is the living monument for Kanakamma. For some time, she acted as a member of AICC. The sprawling Kasturi Devi Vidyalayam campus extended about 23 acres is living monument of Kanakamma. For some time, she acted as a member of AICC. She also acted as a president, vice president of Andhra Congress Committee. After she lost her daughter, M. Venkat Subbamma, in 1934, who was a budding writer and social worker, she became a devotee of Ramana Maharshi and Ramayogi of Annareddy Palem. Ponnaka Kanakamma and Dronaraju Lakshmibayamma were the first two twin poetess in Telugu. They wrote several philosophical poems on Ramana Maharshi. Important one were the Aradhana and Naivedyam. They translated the essence of Bhagavad Gita into Telugu by the name Jnana Netram. Kanakamma wrote the autobiography of Sri Ramana Yogi both in Telugu and English. She founded Jamin Raitu Telugu Weekly at Nelluru in support of Jamindari Raitu movement in Nelluru district. She lost her property during the tyranny and repression of Venkatagiri Jamindar. Her short stories, essays and poems are published in Anasuya, Gurhalakshmi, Hindu Sundari, Bharati, Jamin Raitu, like several newspapers. She established an industrial training center for underprivileged women. During her life, she hosted many eminent freedom fighters and poets at her residence in Potlapudi. She is the recipient of Gruhalakshmi Swarna Kankanam, Sanmanam, Felicitation, that is Felicitation. In connection with the Silver Jubilee celebrations of Madras Mahila Sabha organization, Srimati Durgabai Deshmukh honored Kanakamma with a silver plaque. Kanakamma and all other families, her family members, are writers whose writings are found in Bharati and other magazines. Her youngest brother, Kalaprapurna Marapuru Kondarami Reddy, is a famous journalist and noted writer. She founded Jamin Raitu, a Telugu weekly, in the support of the Jamin Raitu movement in the Nelluru district. Ponna Kanakamma died in Nelluru in 15th September 1963. This is about the Kanakamma. I think it will be helpful to you to write a good essay on her activities. Good luck to you all.